Get the comprehensive guide to understanding which tools you should use for your SQL migration to Azure this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed SQL Insider Series. And today we have Nadia, who is a cloud solution architect. Nadia, thanks so much for joining us today. Can you kick us off by telling us a little bit about what you do?
Yeah, hello, Anna. Hello, everybody. So I'm Nadia Abnelkadi. I'm working for Microsoft France, and I'm a cloud solution architect on data and AI technology. And I mostly focused on all the stuff around data modernization and data migration.
Awesome. Cool. So you're the perfect person to have on the show to tell us a little bit about all the different migration tools and all the different options that there are today. And I think your customer experience gives you like great insight and experience, like actually understanding what people use, what challenges they face, that sort of thing. So I think maybe it would be great if you could kick us off by telling us a little bit about all the different tools that are available today for migration.
Yeah, sure. Before going through the list, specifically to SQL migration and modernization, I would like first to introduce the different steps we need to go through when we wanted to do a SQL Server migration to Azure. We have different phases, and it's the phases that are here on the slide. You have the discovery phase, where we generally do some kind of inventory because we need to be sure that we do not forget anything as part of your migration journey. Then after the discovery phase, we have an assessment phase. And this phase will allow you to decide what will be the best target services in Azure. Once you have set the assessment phase, then you will have a better view about what service you can use for your application in Azure. Then we will go through the migration phase. And the migration phase is the phase where you are going to migrate the data from your on-premise server to the cloud. The step number four is the one where you are going to optimize your workload because you will be on another services in the cloud. So you will need probably to do some optimization to have a better optimized experience for your workload. Then finally, you will have the secure and managed steps, which is in fact something that you will probably do regularly. So you will secure your data, you will use all the management operation that you can use to be sure to have a good experience about managing, operating, and monitoring. So this is the mainly important step as part of the SQL migration. So now, if we want to go more deeper about the migration tools themselves, we will mainly focus on the first step, which are the discovery, the assessment, the migrate step. So let's go more through inside those steps and see what tools are available at this level. So for the discovery phase, you may have different kind of tools. You may have your own inventory tools that will allow you to be sure to collect all the information about your data platform you wanted to migrate. Or you can use some Microsoft tools. We have, for example, the Map Toolkit tools, the Microsoft Assessment and Planning Toolkit that will allow you to do an inventory about all your on-premise footprints. This is a tool that you download and that you run against your on-premise data center. But if you prefer use a PaaS services and other PaaS services, you can use Azure Migrate. And Azure Migrate is a PaaS services that allow you to generate what we call an appliance that you will be able to deploy on your on-premise data center. And it will do for you the discovery phase. What is interesting with Azure Migrate is that it allows you to do the dependency check. Because remember, when you are doing migration from on-prem to the cloud, you really need to forget anything. You need to be sure that all the other server, all the application that connect to your database backend are also moving or are also being connected to your target architecture in Azure. And the dependency graph that Azure Migrate propose you really will help you in that phase. The assessment phase, then, you will be able to use mainly two tools. You can use the DMA, the Data Migration Assessment Tools, which will allow you to scan your on-premise SQL Server and do an assessment for a specific target. For example, you can run the DMA and say, okay, this is my SQL Server on-premise. I want it to go to an Azure SQL Managed Instance Post Services. What should I do before? If there is any blocker or deprecancy that can block me. So the DMA will help you in that phase and will give you all the information about the assessment output. There is on the other side, the Azure Data Studio. Azure Data Studio is a tool that we have since now SQL Server 2017. And one of the advantages of ADS is that it can be deployed on any platform. You can run Azure Data Studio on a Windows boxes, on a Linux boxes, or a macOS boxes, while DMA can only be installed on the Windows boxes. So it depending of the target architecture you wanted to choose, where you wanted to deploy these tools, you will use one or the other one. Another interesting of Azure Data Studio is that it allows you to assess SQL Server, but it also allows you to assess, for example, Oracle workload to see if it is eligible to some Azure SQL PaaS services. So this is mainly depending of what you wanted to assess and what kind of result you wanted to use. You will use one or another one. For the migration phase, you will also be able to use ADS if you wanted to use Azure Data Studio for the migration, because now in Azure Data Studio, we have now an extension that is called SQL Migration Extension that will allow you to migrate your SQL Server to an Azure SQL Managed Instance. You can also perform some migration with DMA, but DMA can only do migration to an Azure SQL databases or an Azure SQL in a virtual machine. So the target choice that you will have in your target architecture will tell you which tool you will use. Are you going to migrate to an Azure SQL Managed Instance? So Azure Data Studio is the best tool to use. You want it to migrate to Azure SQL databases? Well, DMA can do that. But DMA and ADS are tools that you download, you install locally, and you perform the migration. At the opposite, we have an Azure services that can do the migration for you. The service is called Azure Database Migration Services. So if you do not want to download a specific tool for a migration and you want it to use Azure to be used for all the migration process, then you can use Azure Database Migration Services, which is the Azure PaaS services that can be used for their migration. And in that case, you do not have to download the specific tool to do that. This is mainly the tools that we can use. Azure Migrate can also be used for the migration, but Azure Migrate will mostly be used for lift and shift. For example, you wanted to migrate your SQL Server VM to an Azure SQL VM. So for all lift and shift scenario, Azure Migrate will be the best tools to use.
Okay, awesome. This is super useful. And, you know, I know there's a lot of tools out there and you've given us kind of some pros and cons to each or when you might use what, which one. Is there like a list of best practices or some sort of summary that kind of helps people figure out which tool they should use?
Yeah, sure. Look, what I have summarized in this slide, it's some question you will have to answer to find the best tool to use depending on your scenario. So this question will help you create a decision tree to find the best tools for the assessment as well as for the migration. So the first question you have to ask to yourself is, how many databases do I need to migrate? If you only have one or two databases to migrate, you can use the UI tools, launch DMA or ADS to do the assessment and the migration. But as soon as you wanted to do a migration at scale with 100 and 100 databases, which is what generally customers want to do, you probably are going, and it's better to use the Azure Migrates for the inventory and upload your assessment to Azure Migrate, because when you are running your assessment through the DMA, you can upload all the reports of the DMA in Azure Migrate. And you will have in Azure Migrate a central hub that will have all the information of the assessment of your databases. So this is the first question you have to ask to yourself. The second question, once the assessment is done, is what targets I have to choose. Do I have to choose SQL VM, SQL DB, or SQL MI? As I told you before, depending on the target architecture, the migration tools will depend on that. You are going to move to Azure SQL Managed Instance? Well, use Azure SQL, use Azure Data Services or Database Migration Services if you wanted to migrate through a post services. You wanted to migrate to Azure SQL Database? You can use the DMA or the DMS. So this is an important question that you have to answer to be sure also which tools to use. Then another stuff we still not talk about it is how long of downtime your application can support for the migrations. This is really an important question to ask to yourself, because sometimes customers that are doing migration from on-prem to Azure, they have huge databases to migrate with large volume of databases, and they cannot stop the production for all the times the migration is taken. And to answer that question, all the migration tools have the capability to choose between online migration and offline migration. In an offline migration, the application downtime will start when the migration starts. So generally, you will use offline migration probably for small databases or if your application can support a long time for the downtime. The DMA supports only offline migration. You cannot do online migration with DMA. If you wanted to do online migration, then you should use Azure Data Studio ADS or DMS, Database Migration Services. So this is really an important question to ask to yourself depending on your SLA for the migration purpose. Last but not least is how you are going to send the data from your source server to your destination server. So if you cannot use the DMS because DMS need to access your local on-premise infrastructure, then you can use ADS, because ADS and DMA are using what we call the push mode. It means that it's the source databases that can send the data to, for example, a blob storage in Azure, and then the DMS will restore this data on your target server. The DMS is using the pull mode. It means that the DMS will need to connect to the server, then to take the data and then send them to the target services. Just to give you more information, what is behind the scene, the Azure Data Studio use behind the scenes the DMS for all the synchronization. And the technology that is used behind the scene is the log chipping technology. It means that when you are migrating your data with Azure Data Studio or DMS, what we are doing behind the scene is that we are taking the backup of the transaction log that are sent to Azure, and then this transaction log are restored on your target server. So this is how we do the online migration. So when you are using online migration, at a certain time, you will have to do what we call a cutover. And what we will do the cutover is that it will stop the migration, restore the last transaction log, and put the destination databases in a read-write mode. So, and it is only this period of time where your application will have downtime.
Got it. Cool. This is super helpful when it comes to thinking about what we should use. And there's a lot of considerations. Like, is there some summary? You mentioned a decision tree. Like, is there some summary view where we can kind of quickly figure out a wonderful?
Yeah, good question, Anna, because many customers really want to have a summarized view about each tools and the different on depending on the different answers of the question we have talked just before. So this matrix summarizes all the information you need to have. For each tools, for example, for the DMA, for the ADS, the DMS, and the Azure Migrate, all the answers to this question. For example, you wanted to migrate to post services, to Azure SQL Managed Instance, so you see that you can do that for Azure Data Studio or Database Migration Services. You wanted to use the post services for the migration, so your solution is the DMS. For online, offline, this table is also very interesting. If you wanted to do online migration to Azure SQL MI, so you see that Azure Data Studio can help you as well as DMS. And the choice here will depend about, do you want to have on-premise an infrastructure that will manage the migration, or you want Azure to manage the migration for you? Because when you use the DMS, all the provisioning of the number of vCores, the capacity needed for the migration will be taken by the DMS. So it's really be helpful to give you the best choice depending on your needs. Another stuff that is interesting in this table is that you have the information about where do you find these tools. Database Migration Assistant and ADS, you need to download it and install it. While DMS and Azure Migrate, it's an Azure services. So you just need to connect to the portal and access the different tools through the portal, or of course from scripting. So, and it's also another question customer are asking to us, can I script the different tools? The answer is yes. So you can use scripting for all these tools. So if you want to automate the migration process, it's something that you can do and that you can automate with all these tools.
Awesome. This is super comprehensive. I love the flow. What's the process? What are the questions I need to ask? And once I have the answers, what tool do I use? So thank you so much for that. The next question I think is, of course, like, okay, so now that I know, like, how do I get started with these tools?
Yes, good point. I have put in this slide the useful link where you will find all the information I shared with you today. So we have a really nice guide, which is called the Azure Data Migration Guide. If you go through the datamigration.microsoft.com, you will have all the guides for all the scenario with all the step-by-step and the prerequisites. So really, you can go to this portal and you will find all the information, the download link for the different tools and stuff like that. Another interesting program that we have is the Azure Migration and Modernization Program. And you will have the link as part of this session. It is the AMP program. If you have a migration project, if you have a modernization program, you go to this page, you will find all the information you need. You can also ask for help as part of this program and ask how we'll receive all the best practices and all the help with all the partners that can help you as part of the migration. And last but not least, I know Anna and Mohamed, you have last month recorded a very interesting session on Azure Data Studio and extension for the SQL migration to Azure SQL Management. And it was really a nice session with a really nice demo. So I really encourage everybody to go through this video. It was a really nice video with all the demo that you have done with Mohamed. So this is also a useful link I would like to share.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much for coming on the show. Before we close, do you have any final tips and tricks for folks maybe just getting started with SQL migration or as they go on this migration journey?
Yeah, sure. Well, if you think about migration at scale, which is mainly all what customers want to do. Migration at scale is really something that you should think about. And as soon as you have many servers to use, think about using Azure Migrate, because it's really a central hub where you will be able to centralize all the information on the assessment for the SQL part, for the Windows part, for you VMware or Hyper-V hypervisor. So when we are performing migration at scale with our customer, we mainly do the collection, upload to Azure Migrate, and when the Azure Migrate give you the central view, we are after that able to choose the right tools for the right migrations.
Awesome. Well, great advice. Thanks so much again for coming on the show. To our viewers, thanks for tuning in. If you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like. Check the description for all the links that Nadia shared. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.